हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड टाइम टू ऑल। आई एम चंदन कुमार प्रधान। वेलकम टू यूट्यूब चैनल चंदन फिजिक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिलेशन बिटवीन इलास्टिक कंस्टेंट्स। लेट्स बिगिन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इलास्टिक कंस्टेंट्स। दिस कंस्टेंट्स लाइक यंग्स मॉडुलस, बॉक मॉडुलस, मॉडुलस ऑफ रिजिडिटी एंड पॉइजन्स रेशियो। इन दिस वीडियो we are going to discuss the relations among these elastic constants. Let's see to the pen and paper. First, relation between Young's modulus y, k and sigma. To derive or to implement the relations in between these elastic constants, let us consider a cube whose sides each of length small l are parallel to the coordinates to the coordinate axis x, y and z. You have to draw the cube. The coordinates are x, y, z. Now the cube is subjected to a uniform normal, or we can say a tensile stress P, that is normal, or we can say the tensile stress P over each faces of that of cube. Tensile stress P on that face. P here, this face and the lower face. The tensile stress P acted upon uniformly over the faces of that of cube. Compression parallel to y and z axis occurred as the stress P acting parallel to x-axis will produce extension parallel to x-axis. Look here, when stress P is applied parallel to that x-axis, when we stress P is applied parallel to x-axis, that's why a compression executed parallel to both y-axis and z-axis. As a stress P is applied parallel to x-axis, that's result a compression in that of parallel to the axis y and z-axis. Same argument. Holds for y and z axis. Similarly, we can also say when extension produces along y axis, that's why compression takes place parallel to both x axis and z axis. Again, when extension produces parallel to z axis, as a result, compression takes place parallel to both x-axis and y-axis. Now, the linear strain along x-axis due to tensile stress along x-axis is given by P by Y. P is the stress, Y is the Young's modulus. How is it takes place? Although we know Young's modulus is equal to, that is, longitudinal stress divided by longitudinal strain, or we can say that is stress to strain, which implies stress is equal to, strain is equal to stress divided by Young's modulus. We just implement this. The linear strain along y axis due to that of tensile stress is equal to P by Y, that is stress is equal to P by Y is the Young's modulus. But the lateral strain P along x axis due to tensile stress along y axis is minus sigma P by Y. How is it possible? We know sigma is equal to, that is, Poisson's ratio, that is lateral strain to that of लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेन, व्हिच इंप्लाइज लैटरल स्ट्रेन इज इक्वल टू दैट इज सिग्मा इंटू लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेन, लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेन व्हिच इंप्लाइज लैटरल स्ट्रेन इज इक्वल टू सिग्मा लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेन दैट इज पी वाई वाई, लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेस दैट इज पी वाई सॉरी लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल स्ट्रेन दैट इज स्ट्रेन, स्ट्रेस पी वाई दैट इज पी वाई वाई, पी बाय वाई दैट इज सिग्मा पी बाय वाई एंड इट विल बी नेगेटिव, व्हाई इट विल बी नेगेटिव, द नेगेटिव साइन मीन्स नेगेटिव साइन मीन्स कंप्रेशन एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, व्हेन एक्सटेंशन विल बी टेक्स प्लेस अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस दैट्स व्हाई कंप्रेशन विल बी टेक्स प्लेस अलोंग वाई एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस अकॉर्डिंगली ऑल थ्री एक्सिस सेम आर्गुमेंट दैट फॉर वाई एंड जेड एक्सिस दैट्स व्हाई नेगेटिव साइन इम्प्लीमेंट फॉर दैट ऑफ मीनिंग ऑफ कंप्रेशन. सिमिलरली स्ट्रेन प्रोड्यूस्ड अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस ड्यू टू टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस अलोंग जेड एक्सिस इज हाउ मच माइनस सिग्मा पी बाय वाई. सिमिलरली कंसीडरिंग अदर टू पेयर्स ऑफ व्हाट टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस अलोंग वाई एक्सिस and z axis, the resultant strain along x or y or z axis is given by the resultant strain will be how much p by y minus sigma p by y minus sigma p by y is equal to p by y taking common that will be 2 1 minus 2 sigma. Let take it as equation 1. The volume strain how much this is for one axis, the strain the volume strain we multiply 3 that is 3 p by y 1 minus 2 sigma is the volume strain, but we know bulk modulus that is k or we can say it as kappa equal to p divided by volume strain. This is the stress by strain which implies k is equal to p volume strain, that is 3PY 1 minus 2 sigma. Simplifying, we have K is equal to Y divided by PP cancel out, 3 whole into 1 minus 2 sigma. This is the required expression. For what? This is the relation between Y, K and sigma. Now, how we find out the relations in between Y, K and sigma? We consider a cube and use the tensile stress concept accordingly. Use a simple concept, that is when we implement a stress along x axis, that is parallel to x axis, or extension takes place along x axis, as a result compression takes place along y axis and z axis respectively. Accordingly, we calculate all the mathematical formulas by using the concept. Finally, the relation between yk and sigma. Now, relation between y eta and sigma. Again, we consider a cube subjected to tensile stress or we can say the extensional stress. P along x axis and compressional stress P along y axis, but there is no stress along z axis. We just implement the stress along x axis and y axis. Look at the how we take that of figure. X, Y, Z, pressure created as you take P and P in that of upper and lower face, that is why the extension takes place along X and Y axis. How the concepts it will be executed to. Hence, the linear strain along x axis due to tensile stress along x axis is given by P by Y as we already discussed in the first case, and strain along x axis due to compressional stress along y-axis is given by plus sigma p by y. So the resultant strain along x-axis is, we add all this p by y plus sigma p by y is equal to p by y taking common 1 plus sigma, as you take only x and y axis, not z axis, only 2, equation number 4. Similarly, the resultant strain along y and z axis are, in y axis, that is p by y plus sigma p by y, and for z axis, that is minus sigma p by y plus sigma p by y, that is nothing, 0 respectively. So the simultaneous equal extensional and compressional strains at right angle to each other in the sense, that is x and y axis, as we consider not z axis, are equivalent to shear strain. Let shear strain be the theta. Therefore, theta is equal to p by y 1 plus sigma plus p by y 1 plus sigma. This is for y, that is also for x. These two are same, we just add these two, which implies theta is equal to 2 p by y 1 plus sigma, which implies p by theta is equal to y divided by 2 1 plus sigma. P by theta is nothing, that is eta. Eta is equal to y divided by 2 whole into 1 plus sigma. What is p by theta? Where eta is equal to p by theta, that is shearing stress divided by shearing strain. Stress by strain, that is nothing, that is modulus of rigidity. Modulus of rigidity means, that is eta, simple shearing stress by shearing strain, that is modulus of rigidity. Eta is equal to y divided by 2 1 plus sigma, which is the relation between y, eta and sigma. Now, we find out the relation between y, eta and sigma. Taking the same cube, use the simple concept and treat it mathematical way, calculate all these things. Again, taking a equation, let equation number 6, relation between y, k, eta. Now, from first case we find the relation as k is equal to y divided by 3 equivalent to 1 plus 2 sigma. From equation 3, k is equal to eta divided by 3 whole into 1 minus 2 sigma, which implies 1 minus 2 sigma is equal to y divided by 3k, sorry, that is y 3k. Similarly, from last relation, from equation number 6, similarly from equation 6, eta is equal to y 2 plus 2 sigma, which implies 2 plus 2 sigma is equal to y by eta. Adding the above two equations, we get, that is 1 minus 2 sigma plus 2 plus 2 sigma is equal to y by 3k plus y by eta. Add these two, which implies 2 sigma cancel out, that is 3 is equal to y by 3k plus y by eta, which implies 3 is equal to y as common, 1 by 3k plus 1 by eta, or we can say 3 by y is equal to 1 by 3k plus 1 by eta. Or multiplying 3 on both sides, that is 9 by y is equal to 1 by k plus 3 by eta. This one is a relation. Again, when we take the LCM, 9 by y is equal to, that is eta k eta plus 3k, which implies 3k y whole into eta plus 3k is equal to 9 eta k, which implies y is equal to 9 eta k divided by eta plus 3k. This is again a relation. The relation between Young's modulus, modulus, bulk modulus and modulus of rigidity, that is the relation between yk and yk and eta. Final one, sigma in terms of eta and k. How we find out this sigma in terms of n and k? From the relation 3k 1 minus 2 sigma. This is the first relation, and again y is equal to 2 eta 1 plus sigma. This is the second case relation. That's why we get equating these two. These two are equal. That's why 3k 1 minus 2 sigma is equal to 2 eta 1 plus sigma, which implies 3k minus 6 sigma k is equal to 2 eta plus 2 eta into sigma, which implies 3k minus 2 eta is equal to 2 eta sigma plus 6k sigma, which implies sigma 6k plus 2 eta, taking as common, is equal to 3k minus 2 eta, which implies sigma is equal to 3k minus 2 eta divided by 6k minus 2 eta. This is the relation, that is sigma in terms of eta and k, or we can say it as a kappa. Throughout the entire video, we understand relations between elastic constants. First case relation between yk and sigma. That is relation between yk and sigma. Second, relation between y, eta and sigma, simple physical concept, how stress and strain are produced accordingly, a simple mathematical formula is produced, and finally, the relation between y, eta and sigma. Relation between yk and eta, and final one, that is sigma in terms of eta and kappa. So, with this useful and informative notes, let me wind up this session. Thank you.